distressing through airbrushing your Daredevil cosplay. I'm going to show you how. Being that Marvel is on the cusp of getting the rights back to Daredevil, I decided to battle worn, to distress my Daredevil cosplay that I've had for a couple of years now. And I'm thinking about getting the screen printed one, but it has to be to my specs. But in the meantime, I really love the design that I came up with, and I thought that it was time to give it a different look and make it look like we've been in a fight. So this is how we do it. Okay, so I got a very clean Daredevil suit, and I am using a Pache single action airbrush. You can use a double action, a Niwata, whatever, and not pressing down on the nozzle really hard. I'm staying approximately 6 inches away as to not get any hard lines, and you can already see the shading going in there. All right, and it's a nice shade. It's not a hard shade because, first of all, I'm not pressing down on the button all the way down, because that's going to give you more air pressure. And with the double action, if you pull it back, that's going to give you more paint flow. With this, it's an adjusting of the needle in the front, and it will decrease the paint flow. So I'm doing the ab section, getting in some areas, some of the seam lines, not really hard, but so that it's noticeable and doesn't look too clean. Now, I'm not going to beat this up a lot. I just want to make it a little bit more real world looking than just coming out of the box, especially since I've had it a couple of years. And here I'm doing some of the back. And here's the scapular area, the upper shoulders and stuff. And it's coming out really cool. I was afraid to touch this one because I actually like a clean Daredevil. But I'm interested in getting the screen printed one, and I'm going to airbrush that one myself. So I decided to just have fun with this and let go. And I love this suit, and it's about time. So I think with the new cowl that I got for it, it's really going to pop really well. So as you can see, I go in areas where I have to lift up a collar or whatever. And, you know, take your time, have fun. You're going to have to probably tip the airbrush thing, because the tip of it, it's called tipping. You wipe it, because acrylic tends to dry very quickly. And so sometimes you may even have to clean the needle off in between. And there I'm going into the shoulder guard and some of the, you know, seam lines in there. And, you know, it's a fun little project to do, you know. And it's about time to really do it. I, you know, get a little bit on the rivets as well. And, you know, that also little dirty rivets kind of make it look really, really cool. And, you know, change shoulders, doing the right shoulder now, you know. And with this, you don't have to be as consistent, because it's, you know, it's just a little bit of distressing. So you don't have to build muscle tone or ab tones as I normally do when I designed the Wolverine costume that White Sheep Leathers cataloged. So, going back into the back again, because I think it needed to be a little bit darker, and something on the spine, because, you know, it makes sense that if Daredevil was hit and he fell on his back, then, you know, his spine would get dirty as well. So I did some of that, and now I'm distressing the pants a little bit. You know, just getting it to match, and not much to do on the leather on this. Okay, so I'm really going on the four-way stretch is where I'm doing it, and, you know, getting those little side edges. I also edited out some parts where I'm just changing, where I'm putting this on the canvas, so my tripod, I mean. But you can see the difference from start to finish. You know, here's the back, and of course I have to, you know, dirty up Hell's Kitchen's ass, so to speak. And you know, once again, I'm having a lot of fun with this here, and it gives me something to do, you know, take my mind away from all the stuff that's happening out in the world, and sharing some of my cosplay tutorials with you know, with my followers, and hopefully you guys are learning a little bit about airbrushing. And do not practice on your costumes. I did mention that a couple of times, but I see people doing it, and don't. So here you can get a better look of what it looks like now. I'm gonna put it on in a few, but I want to show you that, hey man, you know, I'm really, really impressed with what I did over here. And not patting myself on the back, but it does look pretty kick-ass without overdoing it. So I can't wait to get the stretch one, just having them do a little bit of adjustments to it. But with this, I'm totally happy with it. I just fell in love with it all over again. I did do the belt, but I didn't record myself doing the belt. So now I'm getting ready to do a test fitting and stuff. And so here I am wearing it. It matches the cowl. I painted the cowl as well to match it. And just threw everything on, and I kind of like the dirty look on this. It's really, really cool. There goes the back. And so now you can see there's been no light adjustments or anything. You know, this is the color from my camera, how it looks. And I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial on how to airbrush Daredevil or whatever.
And that, my friend, is how you airbrush battle damage weather properly your cosplay suits that are either made out of screen textured fabric, leather, four-way stretch, cordura, all of the above. I won't say with Lycra, you know, that's a little bit different, but I'm sure that it can work on that. And I hope that you learned a lot. If you did, or if you didn't, if you have any questions, don't forget to leave a comment below, and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. Don't forget to hit the like, the subscribe, and the notification. Tell a friend to tell a friend. And once again, if you're not really good with an airbrush and you want some, you know, something done that's gonna look cinematic or good or better or whatever, hire somebody other than, you know, doing it yourself, unless you practice a lot first, because you can take one of those suits that you've got from Leather Fashion Valley or White Sheep's Leather or wherever, or, you know, chances are if you made it yourself, then you probably can paint it yourself. And have a professional do it. I offer those services, but there's probably an airbrush artist in your area that you can take them some photos and they'll do it. Okay? So once again, this is your boy Rick Legendary.